What's up, guys? Chris Lightning here, and I am back with another vlog. I hope you guys have been enjoying my vlogs so far. I've enjoyed making them and editing them, definitely. But let's see. Today is Tuesday that I'm recording this vlog, so I don't know when this vlog will actually go up. I've been kind of behind on putting vlogs on YouTube. Hopefully, by the time you, well, I mean, by the time By the time you see this, I'll definitely have all the others up. So I don't know when this one will go up. I'm hoping to start editing and finishing and uploading my like some earlier vlogs, hopefully by the end of the week. I'm thinking that maybe I can finish editing Thursday, hopefully. Hopefully, used to finish editing Thursday, and then finally uploading it on like Friday night. You know, it just depends. I can't really do it during the day because I've got school. So, yeah, I'm trying to do YouTube and school at the same time. So it's sometimes it doesn't work, but you know, you do what you gotta do. So, but anyway, I just wanted to bring up. I think I did. I bring it up in the last vlog. I don't know. I know I brought it up in a vlog, but I don't know which one it was. But yeah, what I want to do is, I want to do a question and answer video. So if you guys have any questions for me, just put them in the comments below. And you know, I don't think that this Q&A is going to be a very long one because there's not that many people who actually watch my videos yet. But I'm hoping for just at least a few questions. And you know, although probably with my luck, they're probably questions I can't answer. But no, I doubt you do that to me. But yeah, if you, I want to do a question and answer video. So if you've got a question for me, even a silly question, you know, just comment below. So and I'll see what I can do to answer it. So, but yeah. Oh, and also, don't forget to like my Facebook page and follow me on Instagram and Twitter. And I've also got I find I find I've also got a Snapchat account for my Chris Lightning page, but not for Lightning Vlogs. I mean, but also, but I do have a Lightning Vlogs Facebook page. So, I have one for my main channel, Chris Lightning, and then a second one for Lightning Vlogs. So, which I'll leave a link in the description for all of those, and I'll leave the username for Snapchat in the description. Can't leave a link. There's no web-based Snapchat. So, but yeah, I hope you guys are enjoying this, and we'll just see what this day has to come. So.
Hey guys. All right, right now I'm in a practice room. I'm practicing with my tuba. I don't think in my vlog yet I've showed you guys my tuba, so you know. Let me hang on. Let me put this right here. Oh, okay, that actually worked better than I thought it would. Okay, well, here is my tuba. Nice, right? This is a Treveni piggy tuba. For those of you who that care, this may not be the most interesting thing I've ever done in my vlog, but you know. Let me see. I can't remember what the guy's name was, but he had a Treveni piggy like this, or maybe it was this one. I don't remember. But he was able to, with this tuba, with a tuba like this, was able to get into. Well, he aced his audition with the Nashville Symphony, and he was able to get in and was one of the principal tubists. Well, you know what I mean, of the Nashville Symphony. And that is just like it blew my mind when I heard that. So I was like, okay, I gotta get one of these kinds of tubas. These are awesome. It's a little small, if you can see, like it's kind of hard to see. Oh, this is gonna be bad. I can already tell. It's probably hard to tell on the screen. This is actually let me move the camera a little bit. Sorry, it's not centered. There we go. This tuba is not full size. It is a 3/4 tuba. Full size tuba is usually 4 4 4. And this is a 3/4, so it's 3/4 tuba. And I've gotten a lot of flack about it over the years. Like, oh man, your tuba's small. Like, yeah, well, so what? I'm not good with comebacks, but I don't care either. So, but yeah, and this tuba, it was kind of funny. After I got this tuba, I had it for about 2 months, 2.5 months. I got it like in March, I think. Like, it was the end of March, so I guess probably about less than 2 months actually. It was literally the day of graduation. We were in like this little back room where they kept all of our all the seniors. It was obviously my graduation, but it was my graduation day and from high school. And my father, he came running into that back room where all the seniors were, and he was frantically looking for me because he wanted to tell me that he broke my tuba. He was carrying it in, and apparently he was carrying it upside down, which I don't know why he was, but he was carrying it upside down. And so, hang on, let me take my mouthpiece off so I can show you kind of like what happened. Like, apparently it was in its gig bag, and he was carrying it like this for some reason, and it just dropped out of the gig bag, bell first, and it completely crushed one side of it. It was ridiculous. I mean, I couldn't believe it. it was like, I didn't actually get to take a good look at it until after graduation, and I had to play on it too. Like, at our high school graduation, the seniors, like, the band plays, you know, Pop and Sorber Stance and all that, but they also, like, the seniors play with the high school band one last time, during graduation, and I got to do that, which was awesome, you know. I miss playing in that band too, but I mean, like, I had to play on my tuba, and it was, one side of it was crushed, and I was just like, ugh. And then after graduation, after I got my diploma, I literally ran out to the truck where my tuba was. I opened the gig bag. I took it out with one hand. I looked at it, and I literally just like, I couldn't breathe. I couldn't talk. I was like shocked. I was like, why did this have to happen? Why? Like, I barely had this thing for 2 months, and it's already broken somehow. And so we sent it off to get fixed over the summer, and it took the entire summer for it to get fixed because it wasn't like this part of the bell was the part that got wait, was this part? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, well, it was actually this part of the bell right here. It's hard to see that this is where they undinged it, uncrushed it, however you want to say it. That didn't take hardly any time at all. But what the thing was like the let me show you the part where the mouthpiece goes in right here. This, which I can't remember what the part's called, the shank, the shaft. I don't know. But this part, this is not the original, because this was also broken on it. I don't know if it had been broken before it was dropped or if it broke when it was dropped. But it they had to get a new one from the Czech Republic, and that took literally weeks of just getting it there. And then it took a few days to actually put it on there because they had to solder it together, which actually, they didn't do a bad job soldering it together. But you know, so I got it back literally, let me see, what was it? It was literally like 2 weeks before my college band camp. I got it back. And I played on that thing like for like 3 hours every day for those 2 weeks, just to try and get that sound back I had, because I didn't have another tuba I could practice on. So the whole summer, I didn't have a tuba I could practice on. and I finally got it back. I'm like, yes. And I started up lessons with my lesson teacher again, just so I can hopefully, get my sound back. And also, I had to prepare for my college audition too, like for the college band audition, for the concert band, like symphonic band, wind ensemble, which luckily got into symphonic band somehow. But I mean, it was just I had only had this thing for less than 2 months, and it broke, and it was just, golly, it was like one of the worst times of my life. Oh my gosh. But man, this tuba, and probably once I get out of college, I'll probably sell this thing, and buy a different tuba, probably buy a better tuba. Probably a full size tuba, which will be different for me because, let me see, well, I played on a full size in college, in high school,
throughout my senior year, I played on a full size Yamaha, I think it was. Yeah, I think so. Which that thing was a beast. I tell you what, man. But the thing is like that tuba that one I played on in high school, that one was tuned in B flat. It was pitched in B flat. This one I have right now is a C tuba. So that means that, like, when I, well, let me go back a little bit. When I switched, let's say I used to be a trumpet player, which on a B flat trumpet will be the same fingerings for a C tuba player like me, like this. But when I switched from B flat trumpet to a B flat tuba. Wait, did I say tuba twice? I think I did. When I switched from B-flat trumpet to B-flat tuba, I had to learn all the fingerings, like, down a half step. So, like, instead of my C being open anymore, it was 1 and 3. Let me just give you, like, a little bit of an example. A B-flat trumpet, their B-flat is like a C tuba D flat. It's one, like a B flat scale would be, B flat is one, C is open, D is 1 and 3, E flat is 2 and 3, an F would be 1, G would be open, A natural, A would be 1 and 2, and then again B flat would be 1, and that's a B flat scale for both B flat trumpet and for C tuba. Yeah. And so I had to learn all of them a half step down. Like, a B flat scale for a B flat tuba would be B flat is open all the time. So it'd be like B flat would be open, C would be 1 and 3, D would be 1 and 2, E flat would be B flat, C, D, it'd be 1. E flat would be 1. F, I believe, would be open, if I'm correct about that. Yeah. Darn it, I lost my place. But anyway, it's just, you know, it was basically, let me see. B flat, C, D, E flat, F, G, bum, I think, I don't know. I'm confused now. I've confused myself. It made sense to me in high school, but now I play on a C tube, and so I had to learn all the trumpet fingerings again, basically, once I switched. And I switched, like, I played that B flat tuba only, like, not that, I played that 4-4 tuba not that long. I only played on it for, like, 2 months, two months, 2.5, 3 months, something like that. And then I got this tuba, And I started playing on it in my high school concert band, and I learned the fingerings. I didn't learn the fingerings as quickly as you'd think I would have learned them since I played trumpet, but you know I learned them eventually. So, I know that none of you have actually seen my tuba before, but I've have you? I've never actually seen it in my hand before. Let's just say it like that. And maybe you guys were wondering. I don't know, but. But yeah, this is my tuba. So, and if you guys want to hear me butcher notes, then just leave a comment down below, and I'll leave a comment, and I'll figure something out. Maybe I'll play like something out of this book that my lesson teacher gave me. It's just his little warm up book. It's a basic training book for daily drills and exercises, and he has. Them for like different pitched tubas like B flat and C. I've only seen it for B flat and C, but he could probably write it for F and all that other tuba jargon. So yeah, and I'm sorry if you don't know what I mean by pitched in a certain key, yeah, I'm not good at like explaining that kind of stuff. I can understand it in my head, but I'm not good with like explaining it to other people. That's why I'm not a music education major, because I can't explain things. I can't explain things well. All right. But anyway, yeah, this is my tuba. if you guys want to see me butcher notes on this thing, just leave a like and I'll see what I can do. So. Let's see. I think that's about it for now. We'll see what else this day has, because I didn't actually plan on vlogging a lot today, actually. I didn't know what I was going to vlog, honestly, too. I was just in here warming up for my master class, for a Tuba master class, and I thought, well, you know what? Why not vlog just a little bit with, actually, I've been vlogging for, like, 10, 11 minutes, something like that. Well, 11:50, that's what the camera says. That's how long I've been vlogging. I think that's it for now. I don't know if this will be the end of the vlog or not. But if it is, then I hope you guys have enjoyed it. And leave a like and a comment if you want to see more vlogs. Or if you want me to shut up and never do this again, just hit the dislike button. But anyway, I don't know if this is the end of the vlog or not. I guess we'll find out later today. If I see or feel like anything's going to be interesting, I will try and vlog it. I'm trying to get better at that. It's just my mind. I'm trying to get my mind into a vlogging state when I'm at school so I can show you guys some really cool and awesome things. But I'm just, you know, I'm trying to get into that state of mind because I haven't been in that state of mind, well, ever. So, but yeah. Thank you guys again for checking us out, and I'll see you guys in a bit.